Have a good day, first English students. Now, open at page 221. Open at page 221. And so this video is going to be a short video, and we will discuss passive transformation, participle movement, dative movement. So, participle movement, dative movement, and passive transformation. So, I do not know how to really. I do not know how to explain, because everything you already learnt, and there is nothing new in it. Okay, already you studied grammar, and we are discussing the theoretical aspects of English grammar. Okay, theoretical aspects. So you know, we internalize certain rules. Okay, active voice and passive voice. Unknowingly, we internalize certain rules. And see again, birds fly. Okay, yes. What do you see in the sky? Birds fly. Likewise, we say. Okay, and grammar is, yes, birds, noun, fly, verb. And in sentence pattern, how do you say? So, okay, birds, yes, fly, verb. Likewise, this is to be grammar, okay. We internalize certain rules, and unknowingly we learn, let's say, the traffic, or see, my body needs some energy. Okay, by say for example, my body needs some energy. Okay, and I mean, it's not like an example sentence. Really, if my, if all of our body needs energy, naturally it happens naturally. Okay, for that purpose only I'm saying. Naturally, we feel hungry. Okay, yes, we need some energy. Okay, then okay, our brains are yes, I need to eat something. So that I can be more energetic. Likewise, our brain is structured. Okay. Likewise, language, as far as language is concerned, the rules and the regulations were not made consciously, and for the sake of convenience, we learn grammar. Okay. And what is subject, what is object, what is active voice, passive voice. So the passive transformation, so that is the topic. So passive transformation, what is the structure of the passive transformation? Obviously, object turns object is converted into subject, and subject is converted into object, subject is converted into object, and in passive voice, subject is not doer of the action, and subject receives the action. Okay, so I write a letter, SVO. Okay, so a letter is written by me. So here the subject object becomes subject. See, I write a letter, the object receives the action, and I that is the subject, and subject is the doer of the action. Okay, so this is to be active and passive voice that you all know, and this is the structure. And when you learn active and passive voice, you also already learned the structure of the English structure of passive voice. Okay, so we need to add the word, the preposition by. Okay, so those things are discussed, and so noun, phrase, auxiliary, and verb and noun phrase too. So everything is given here, and the theoretical aspect. So this is the structure of this is the structure of passive transformation. So we need to most importantly, the verb form is changed. Okay, in passive voice, and most importantly, the verb form is changed. That is past participle verb form. Verb 3 is used. Okay, so that is very, very important. and in passive sentences as well as English is concerned. Okay, and the next topic, participle movement. So what do you mean by participle movement? In English language, interestingly, we have a verb phrase or phrasal verb. Let's say phrasal verb. Okay, say phrasal verb, get up, sit down, stand up. Okay, some of us may are saying, some Indians are saying, sit, yes, sit, sit. That is a wrong sentence. Likewise, we just sit. Likewise, we cannot say that is wrong. Just sit down, sit down. That is example of phrasal verb. We cannot simply use the word sit. Sit down, yes, sit down, please. Okay, so get up. Okay, get up from the chair. Get up from the bed. Okay, so get up, G-E-T, that is one word, and up, U-P, up, that is another word. So get up, that is one phrasal verb. It cannot be separated. Okay, so in English language we have this phrasal verb. It cannot, they cannot be separated. Okay, stand. Likewise, we cannot say stand up. At the corner of the room you stand up. At the corner of the room you sit down. Okay, at the corner of the room you sit. Likewise, that is at the corner of the room you sit. This is wrong, grammatically wrong sentence. At the corner of the room you sit down. Okay, so this is said to be a participle movement, and sometimes object is placed between the phrasal verb. Okay, both are correct. There is nothing wrong in keeping the object. So kindly mention in your notes, there is nothing wrong in keeping the object in between the phrasal phrasal verb. Okay, so both are correct. I will pick you up. Okay, I will pick you up. I will pick up you. Both are correct. I will pick you up. Okay, I will pick up you. And other sentences given here. They turned on the light. They turned the light on. Okay, so that is an example given here. Both are correct. They turned on the light. They turned the light on. Okay. And you put down the pen. You put the pen down. Both are correct. Okay. And another sentence. We should never look down on the poor. We should never look down on the poor. Okay. So these phrasal verbs are correct, and we can place the object in between the phrasal verb. And if you don't want to place the object in between the phrasal verb, object may be placed in the last. Everything is correct. There is nothing wrong in it. Okay. And then we have a dative shift. So this is another interesting area in English language. So what is dative shift? That is indirect object and direct object. He gave me a pen. He gave a pen. Okay, grammatically a correct sentence, a perfect sentence. He gave me a pen. Okay, so this is so here he gave me a pen. He gave me. So indirect object, direct object. Okay, so he gave the girl a doll. Okay, he gave the girl a doll. That is this sentence is example sentence given in our book. So he gave the girl a doll. Okay, so here he gave a doll. Okay, obviously clear sentence. So doll is said to be direct object. He gave the girl a doll. Okay, so here the word girl is act as an indirect object in the sentence. Okay, so The same sentence could be written in this way also. This is also correct. He gave a doll to the girl. He gave a doll to the girl. He gave the girl a doll. That is also correct sentence. He gave a doll to the girl. Two preposition is added, and this is also a correct sentence. Okay. So likewise, there are certain listen to. Okay. We cannot simply use the word listen. Listen to me. Listen to Dr. Manoharan. Okay. This is the correct sentence. Listen Manoharan. That is a wrong sentence. Okay. Listen to me. Listen to the radio. Likewise, we have to use them. Okay. So some sentences are given here, and some common verbs which allow indirect object to be thus placed by prepositional phrase and thus shifted are the preposition concerned given in brackets do, for, do to, find for. So something related to this indirect object is used. Okay. So teach to save for prove for see. Promise to. He promised me to help me. Okay. So here the he promised me. Okay. So here SVO. Okay. That is correct sentence. And another when we add to, he promised me to help me. Okay. So likewise the additional